caring for the saints. There's an urgent call for godly and disinterested men as shepherds of God's people, the flock for which the good shepherd gave his life is presently in need of them, men of the sort described by the Apostle Peter, who will feed my flock, which is among you, taking an oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not by filthy lucre, but by a ready mind, neither being lord over God's heritage, but being examples to the flock. And when the chief shepherd shall appear, you shall receive a crown of glory that fadeth not away. 1 Peter 5, verses 1 through 4. Thus will the God-given overseer sincerely and generally look after the flock, and his care will have an appearance of a spontaneous flow from the heart, like the upflow of an artesian well. Of such it will be blissedly true. The heart of the saints are refreshed by thy brother. Philemon 7, Revised Version. This condition comes by sweet communion with God in the sanctuary, and there, relating how precious to the shepherd are the sheep and the lambs of his flock. He who desires this work will often find an honoring in times of pleasure, unpleasant, and even unpopular. He must be prepared for suffering, discouragement, perplexity, and misunderstanding. If prepare for a unique path which true and noble men have trodden, which the Lord's footsteps have marked as his own, then he has need of thee. Beside the unusual work of oversight in well-established assemblies, there is a much need of a wise man with the shepherding heart, set at liberty to visit the little struggling company of believers here and there, some hidden away in the back blocks, some nested in the lower slopes of the range, some in the upper country townships, all needing a sympathetic care for their state. To cast in one's lot with these people of God, scattered abroad for them to live and labor, to cheerfully endure all things for the elect's sake, this will bring its own special rewards of the crowning day coming by and by. A fine example is given in Luke 2, verse 8, to be well remembered. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Like Jacob, they probably could say, thus I was in the day of the drought, consume me, and the frost by night, and my sheep departed from my eyes. Genesis 31, verse 40. In these things also, let's keep before us God's servant Moses, who endured as seeing him who is invisible, and who has respect unto the recompense of the reward. Hebrews 11, verses 24 through 27. The great mustering of the sheep from every land is coming, when the whole flock shall be gathered in the fold above. In view of that time, it behooves us to be busy in the field early and late, counting no toil too much for Christ's beloved sheep.